Hi, this is Jeff Loomis, and these are my top five favorite metal albums of all time. I would say the first real metal album I ever heard was when I went over to a neighbor's house. His name was Scott, lived behind me. He was a piano player, and he had an album called Iron Maiden Peace of Mind. And he put that vinyl on, and that was really my first recollection of hearing metal at its finest. That really inspired me to turn into a metalhead. So Iron Maiden Peace of Mind was the first album I really heard that kind of changed me and made me a metal lover. I would say the second album that got me into metal was Van Halen 1, just because of the sheer sound of the album and the guitar tone is something that really just floored me when I first heard it. Eddie Van Halen's tone, you know, the brown sound going on that album was something that was just phenomenal to my ears. The overall compositions of the songs. I think just the sincerity of a band being a four-piece in the studio playing their stuff with hardly any overdubs. It was just so real to me and something that will always kind of sit with me as one of my all-time favorites. Number three would probably be an album by Queen called News of the World. I remember I was like home sick from school and my dad came up to me. He's like, can I get you something that would make you feel better? I'm like, yeah, buy me a Queen album, Dad. And he came home and he had this album and he handed it to me. One beautiful thing about music back then was just being able to look at the artwork and open up a vinyl and just like, oh my God, this is incredible. And if you remember that album, it has a giant robot, a painting on the front of it holding all of the band members in its hands. And that just gave me this vibe, you know, of something kind of scary and spooky, but listening to the music, it all kind of just came together. And that goes with saying that it's probably one of my favorite albums of all time, News of the World, Queen.
So come and get me, let me. That says my heart is on an all-time low.
Number four, I would have to say the record that basically changed my life as a guitar player, I would say, is Yngwie Malmsteen's first instrumental album that came out in, I believe, 1984-ish, 85, called Rising Force. And that album is one that I just wore out completely. A friend of mine, Jason, who I'm still friends with to this day, had it in his collection and he played it for me, and it was something that I've never heard before in my life. Just the way that the guitar was played and the whole classical vibe of the whole album and Yngwie's approach to just being one of the true pioneers of neoclassical guitar. And I remember taking that album, putting it under my jacket and running home with it, and I never returned it to my friend, and I still have that same pressing to this day. It's all beat up, and it's a phenomenal album, phenomenal instrumental album. I would say the last one would probably be Ozzy Osbourne's Diary of a Madman with Randy Rhoads. This album was produced by Max Norman, who's one of my favorite producers, and he wrote some amazing songs on this album. Very kind of dark and minor, and I think still goes down as one of my all-time favorite Ozzy Osbourne records. So those are my favorite top five albums of all time.